So you want to know what I'm going to do. You're saying to me, what is your plan? What is your plan, man? Dude, I will tell you, I have a plan. It's a good plan. It's constantly shifting. Every day I'm shuffling. But that's because the plan is quite expansive and quite comprehensive, and I like to keep things complex and with many layers to them. So, I'm not going to give you the entire plan today, but I am going to show you something that will help you understand how I'm going to implement the plan. Now, today, I did not go to church. Today, I stayed here in my home, meditating, thinking, wondering, waiting, listening. And I looked at this thing, and I turned it over and over and over with you, because that is what you are doing now. You are wondering to yourself, what does this mean to me? Well, I'm going to tell you what it means to me. To me, it means that my journey has begun. I have a goal in this world, and it is to see that there are no longer people sleeping in the bushes and starving to death in the streets. I have a goal to send all of the soldiers home and end all of the wars. I have a goal to build a society on equality and peace so that ideas like democracy and justice are not necessary to begin with. I have a goal to take this world and transform it for the better, or see it locked out of its rotation and sent hurtling down into the flames of oblivion. And I would like your help in making the best of those two options happen. I would like to be a catalyst, but I would like you to make the choice, just as always. If you are a minister, if you are a light worker, if you are a priest, if you call yourself a servant of the sacred fire and a servant of the holy waters, if you have sacrificed at my altar, if you have prayed in my name, if you consider me your friend, if you know who I am, I have a question for you. What would you do if I came here and I saw how things were today in this country around us here, where people are sleeping outside and being locked in cages for stupid reasons while the rest of you party 365 days a year? You are ignorant of the decisions of your leadership. You are making mistakes with this planet that cannot be reversed. You have caused suffering untold upon billions of people, and you are all sitting around having your morning coffee at the fucking local coffee shop. And you are selling to me on Sunday that you are holy and you are just and you are servants of my teachings and you know my way. And yet there are people living outside in the bushes right next to you, and every day you are walking by them and you are not paying them any attention. Come here and I've seen this, and now you are going to have a reckoning. What happens when someone holds you accountable to that? I have a question for you. Why isn't this world already better than it should be now? You've had leaders like Martin Luther King and Mahatma Gandhi to tell you the way to go, and yet you have not implemented their truths. I am here and I am watching and I am wondering why it is not happening, because from what I can tell, the solution to all of your problems is going to be simple and easy to implement. If all of the churches were open 365 days a year to serve all of your needs for free, then that would be enough. Anyone can go there and make a friend, get something to eat, find a place to sleep, take a bath, get clean, get healed, get listened to, and get some rest. And if that was the way that it was, then there would be no wants and no lacks, and everyone in this world would feel safe and secure, and everything would blossom and be beautiful. There would be no reason for young men to go and sell their souls to pick a fight for other men who can pay them to die in the desert in a foreign land. You are all listening to me now, and I have your rapt attention, and I am going to use it to put this to you. This is the test that I offer to you. This is what I want to know. Why are things not being so lucrative when you know that they can? I am here, I am in Northern California, and I have seen how the people in this land have created an idea and a pattern, a paradigm and a way of life that would be if it was transplanted onto the rest of the world and given some injectors of steroids like my ideas about the churches could transform this planet for the better and salvation of all. You need to have water security, you need to have food security, you need to be able to camp on any open unused piece of land that you wish. And if you cannot do that, then God, what are we waiting for? There is no reason for you to be here. It's time to take this tiny blue marble and smack it out of the sky. Now, I have come here, it is Easter Sunday 2012, and I am waiting for your response. I want to know what you are doing and what you are going to do, because I am ready to see why you are not putting up community gardens and fucking clothing exchanges and making free healthcare for everybody without the help of the government. Why are you even petitioning them? All they do is make a war. You are letting your brothers and sisters be tortured and taken away and locked in cages and treated like animals by the most sadistic of you, and you are putting those people on pedestals and saying it's alright. And this year you are going to continue to follow in the leadership in the wake of this demonstrative fucking democratic joke that you have going on here, where there's no choice and you only get the worst of the worst of the worst. And now I am here and I'm the best of the best. I am the fucking top shaman in the business, and if you want to come and follow me, I will show you the way and I will show you how we will do it. You can email me, you can find me on Facebook, you can listen to me on YouTube. I am not going to stop until these problems are solved and this planet is fixed. And I'm going to let you tear me to pieces, and I'm going to be every last drop of blood in my body to see it happen. And if you do not believe this, then you do not know me, because that is what I've come for, and I've come for nothing else. And if you have heard these words today, I have issued a challenge to you. Now where is your response? I have thrown down the gauntlet. Where is the oil in your lamp? I am waiting for you in the bridal chamber. Come to me and we will save this world together, and then we will all live in paradise. That is my message to you, and that is all I have to say. And now I will tell you, have a good day, and I will see you tomorrow.